As the Father know me, even so know I the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. Other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, not of this pasture, them I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. Therefore, do my Father love me, because I do what? Lay down my life, that I might take it up again. Praise God. Now, if you were going to Philippians, the second chapter, we're going to run through the word here just a little bit. Second chapter, verse 1. There be therefore any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any bowels of mercy. That's the word bowels is if there's any affection. If there's any affection, then it says, fulfill ye my joy. That's what he goes on to say there. Fulfill ye my joy. And Paul is writing and saying that you can fulfill my joy when you have affection one for another, like your Savior has for you. Now, how is this? It says there, we'll keep on going in verse 7 of Philippians, the second chapter. Jesus Christ made himself of no reputation, and he took upon him the form of a servant. Hallelujah. And was made in the likeness of men, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself unto death, even the death of the cross. So God, he so loved us. Jesus was so committed to the plan that he laid down his life even for us. And not only did he just die a death, but he died the most cruel death, the death of the cross for us. Now, John the Baptist was, they thought that John the Baptist was the Messiah at one time. Aren't you the Messiah? John the Baptist says, no, I'm not him. I have told you, and yes, in St. John 3:29, 3 chapter verse 29, I'm not him, and what you need to do is look for another. And I know that as he comes on the scene, I must decrease. And John was saying, if you're not the one, then who should we hear? Because John was doing some great work, John. If you're not him, whom should we hear? And this is the thing about believers today. Who do we hear? Who are we listening to? Now that's competition for your ear drum. There's the radio, Tom Jones. Magazine, Ebony, Tulsa World, newspaper. Broke Uncle Bob and Aunt Nellie. Sick Brother Bill. They have some advice for you. They want to get into your ear and tell you some things. But do you know that most of the time you won't hear from that crowd? He has come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. You're going to hear something contrary. Sickness is a natural thing. Broke is, everybody broke. Money is a problem. Money is evil. Money is this and that. And you're going to hear all of that from that crowd. But whom shall we hear? John said, John the Baptist said, hear ye him. Now I'm going to tell you that in our Sunday school class this morning, a number of us thought that there was only one tree. Some of y'all in here, one tree, in the garden. Because we have read the Bible and studied the Bible from Sunday schools and various places with a border on it. The tree of life. No, there's more than one tree in the garden of Eden. Where is the tree of life? No, yeah, right, but there was more than one tree. Here I'm telling you today that Jesus has come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. There is more to living than what we have experienced. Now, how are we going to get there? The Bible says, and as soon as you believe in it, that you, Jesus came, that you might have life and have it more abundantly. As soon as you buy into that, you're going to experience a difference. Let me tell you about my personal self. My sister can tell you, as a child, I was one of the sickest ones in the flock of the There's pictures, and I'm not even photos because someone else has my toy gun and all like that. I'm laying on the couch, sick. Grandmother taking me to the doctor and all this kind of stuff. So I learned earlier that I hated sickness. I'm somewhere now, and I want to tell you, and she may experience, and I might have told you guys before, I somehow never overcame. I believe it was called an allergy, that every morning when I wake up, I had to clear my nose, clear it out, the whole nine yards. They call it a moose call, and I just get it. Even, I don't know what Jessica is. Jessica can testify. She's somewhere back there, and the kids made fun of me with the moose call every morning. Every morning. That's why I got new kids. Hallelujah. But all of a sudden, and it's got to be since Jessica graduated from high school, I think it was in 1999, was she class of 99? 1999. From there until today, I haven't done a moose call, not one time. And because I bought into that life is in the sun. The God kind of life is in the sun. Now, and I can, and I said, oh boy, Sister Denise, didn't I tell you some years ago, didn't I tell you some years ago I was going to be a what?
Millionaire.
When did I tell you that?
Many years ago.
Glory to God. I was born as a joke when I told you. But I'm telling you right now, I sat, rubbed, talked, fellowship with everybody that was a millionaire this past. Kenny got a 10 sitting next to millionaires. I'm going to tell you, what's so big about that? Because millionaires would say, what are you doing in life? How are you doing it? How are you getting along? And I would tell them, you know what they say? Here's what you do. Here's what you do. You want to be successful in business and life? Here's what you do. Then reading from a book, I got it from the horse's mouth, millionaires. One person had partnered up with me because of his high blood pressure. He had to get rid of some things. But here's his toys in life. He has his own plane. His own plane. He lives right here in Tulsa. He showed me, he says, now when you and I are going to Missouri, here's where we're going to stay. He showed me this, he said, it's just a cabin, log cabin. He showed me the cabin, and he showed me the lakefront view. And he says, this is just my other house. And it's not like, I don't know where the beauty when you go fishing out on the lake. This is something else. Surrounded by a mountain, big old, he says, this is where we're going to stay. And then he says, come on to my house anytime, and his house crosses, you know the neighborhood, but the creek turnpike crosses Highway 75, I believe, maybe something like that. Good, nice neighborhood. Then I have another friend that I met, millionaire. I'm trying to get you into this mindset. I know this guy personally, and I know because he's coming to Tulsa to visit with me. He calls himself my mentor. He makes $30,000 a month. And years ago, he bought into that you might have life and have it more abundant. He says, Donnell, there's not very many people that I say this to, but you're one of them. Call me anytime, any day. And he says, I meant it. The American is right here. In my face, says, I meant it. And then he gave my wife a kiss. I saw him here, brother. Not very people that I tell you this. He says, I'm telling you this. Call me any time of the day, any day. And you and I will work out whatever you do. So, if I read St. John 10 and 10, and I just allow another sound to come into my ear as I read that, then it won't be a reality to me. And if I tell you that, and I say it all the time, I think I ministered last week, how many have ever heard Brother Williams say that he never gets what? And my sister knows for sure, she's a nurse, how much I refuse a what kind of shot? A flu shot. She fusses all the time. Yeah, you take this wheel. She's from the medical profession. Bless her heart. I don't face them. And they never see or experience me being sick. Now, I'm telling you this so that you can hear it, because Jesus said it himself. He told them, I am the good shepherd. But they didn't get it. In St. John 10, he says, I am the good shepherd. And he talked about the sheep hearing his voice. They didn't get it. And then he says, I'm going to explain it to them again. He says, I'm going to say it. Let me break it down to you. I'm the shepherd. The sheep hear my voice. No other voice will they follow. Now this is for you and I today. No other voice should you follow. Now, what is that voice? That voice is simply the Word of God. Say it with me. The Word of God. So, as we look at the Scripture, we're going to see, let's go back once again, let's go to St. John 5:24. St. John 5:24. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believe on him that sent me hath what kind of life? And should not come into condemnation, but is passed from what? Death to life. Verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead should hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear shall what? Live. Now, see, it's all about the voice. It's all about the voice. As the Father hath life in himself, so has he given to the Son to have life in himself. Now, verse 28, don't be surprised at this. The hour is coming in which all that are in the grave should do what? Hear his voice. Let's go to verse 30. I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge. My judgment is just because I seek not my own will, but the will of the Father which had sent me. If I bear witness of myself, my witness is not true. Verse 33. Ye sent unto John, he's talking about John the Baptist, and he bare witness to the truth. But I received not testimony from man, for these things I say, that ye might be saved. He was a burning and a shining light. And you were willing for a season to rejoice in his light. Verse 37, and the Father himself sent me, hath borne witness of me. Ye have neither heard his voice at any time, nor seen his shape. And ye have not his word abiding in you, for whom he has sent him, ye believe not. He says, so the problems that you're having in life right now, the issues you're facing right now that are contrary to you, is because you do not hear the voice of the word that's going to give you life. Oh, man. Now, when I realized that a long time ago, I said, my prescription for good life, for good living, is the Word of God. Now, this is what the Bible says. Thy Word have I hid where? In my heart, that I might not do what? Sin against thee. Another place, thy Word is a light unto my what? Feet. Lamp to my pathway. But I'm telling you, the Ebony Magazine, Tom Joyner early in the morning on the radio first thing, Tulsa War and all like that, it's not life to us. I have nothing against Tom Joyner, but we got more than that stuff, that secular stuff in us, than we do the Word of God. You're taking the wrong prescription. You want health, you want wellness, you want financial prosperity, financial peace, and all of these things that you have a